Alright, so today is the day that we picked up our two steers from the butcher, and this is what two South Pole steers look like when you get them home. Just this number of boxes, and they're all packaged individually in there, and we're going to go through this now and see what we have here for usable product. I believe there's six boxes full of hamburger, and the rest of those boxes are the cuts, if I remember right, as I was bringing them in. Might be another one in that big stack, but the two stacks that are three high are where I put the ground beef. So let's see how this turns out. All right, so the first box here says has the flank steak, tri-tip, flat iron steak, the picanha, brisket, the inside skirt, and the outside skirt. And I'm not sure how they coded this as to which one's from which steer. I think they said the digit here on this side label means something. So let me take a quick look at that. 31. Not sure if that's related to my animal 31 or not. Now they're totally different numbers, but one of them it has a 31 in the number. The other one is 94 in the number. So they're, I don't know which one's which, but that's okay. So anyway, this box totals out at a weight of 29.9 pounds, and so let's take a look at these. Let's see, beef plate inside skirt. Okay, they cut these down into small pieces. So that's that. Side skirt. They're nice little things here, and they put our logo on the package. And I'll paste in a picture of that, show what it looks like. Inside skirt. And here we got outside skirt. Outside. Flank steak, outside, flank, flat iron. So that tells how big they made the flat irons. They look pretty darn good. Pretty pleased at the amount of marbling in that. Outside skirt, flank, another flat iron. There's a tri-tip. Another tri-tip. Another flat iron. Another outside skirt. Here's a picanha. And another picanha. And brisket. Got two of those. So those ones are going to end up going up to the other freezer, so I'm going to leave them right in here the way they are. Same with the picanhas. And the tri-tips. Actually, this whole box is going to end up going back up to the other freezer. They look good though. I'm really happy with that. Let's get some of the ones that I really want to see. Let's get the ribeyes and the strips. This is ribeye bone-in. Ground beef, beef loin T-bone. This is the one, that's the, it's not as all off of where I put the things. But anyway, this is New York strip and sirloin. Let's take a look at those. This is the one I really want to show to y'all as to how these guys turned out, because we should be able to see some marbling on these ones. So I'm gonna bring the camera over closer. Focus in on this. Top sirloin, a few of those. And here's New York strip. Okay, so it doesn't look like, you know, prime, as it shouldn't be. This is grass-fed beef, but there is quite a bit of intermuscular fat there. Here's another one. They look pretty darn good to me. Throw one on the grill a little later and see how they turn out. But, this is all those New York strips and the top sirloins. So I'm gonna leave that all boxed up. That's going up to the other freezer. This one's got tenderloin fillets in it. Let's take a look at that. It's also got some of the same things we've looked at already. Flank steak, beef loin, tenderloin steak. So that's how they made the tenderloins, or fillet. So that's a tenderloin steak, tenderloin, tenderloin, tenderloin. Flat iron. Tri-tip. chuck roast. Here's the ribeye. That's the other one I want to see real well. And there's our ribeye. I think that looks pretty darn good. Again, it's not going to look like a prime grated ribeye because it's grass fed, but it looks pretty good. Quite a bit of fat in there for grass fed. Look at that. Yep. Intermuscular fat there, you can see quite well. Looks good. Looks good. Happy with that. All right. Well, we're going to take one of those out and grill it up too. So we'll do a ribeye and we'll do a New York strip on the grill and show you what those look like and give them a taste test. But, so those ones are gonna go up to the other place. And ground beef is real simple. Had them packaged and 1 pound chubs. So that's what they look like. Pretty simple. All ground beef. And here you can see our logo that they put on there, as long as that focuses. There we go. So there's our logo. Right below that is the USDA inspected tag. You have the product name. You have the our address on here, and all the information at the bottom here that you're required by the USDA to be able to sell this material. So nice. All right, that's that. So this is how the steaks arrive. They're shrink wrapped. They were frozen. These have been thawed out now. What I've got here is a boneless ribeye. I think it looks pretty nice. I've got a big T-bone, which this would be really like a porterhouse. This has got the large section of the fillet and also a very large New York strip section of it. And this is just a New York strip. So you can see there's some marbling. It's not marbled like a prime grain-fed beef, but there's a difference between grain-fed and grass-fed, and that's one of the things that that's typical. There is some marbling there, but it's not as significant as in a grain-fed one. That shouldn't have any kind of influence on the tenderness of it. We'll get these cooked up, and we'll see how this works. I'm going to do the T-bone and the strip on the grill, and I've got a griddle on one side of my my grill here, and I'll do the ribeye on that one. Ribeyes generally like to be not over direct heat, so they don't let out all their fat and cause a fire. So we'll do that one on the flat top section of the grill. And let's see, here's what it looks like. So I've got a grill on this side and a griddle on this side. So that's where we'll be cooking them. Just gotta let the grill heat up just a little bit more. It's only up
400 degrees. It'll typically get up quite a bit higher than that because it's all the dials are on full blast right now. I will get it heated up to a little over 400 degrees or so, 450, and I'll turn it down a little bit to try to hold it somewhere around there, and we'll see how this works. T-bone. I'm going to go on first because it's got the bone in it. It's got to cook. That up and give it about 2-3 minutes on that side, and then we'll flip it over. Okay, so these are cooked, and I've let them rest for about 15 minutes. So let's cut into them, see what they look like. This is the New York strip. So this is the New York strip, and it came out medium, it looks like. Here is the ribeye, the mighty, mighty ribeye. This one should be medium rare. It's the one I ran the temperature probe on, and it looks beautiful. And over here we have the T-bone, which is a New York strip and a fillet in the same steak. So let's cut into the fillet side and see what that looks like. It looks like it's medium as well. It might have gone just a little bit too long for on the strip side. That also is a good medium to medium rare. So we'll give it a taste. That's tasty. On the fillet side. Also very tasty. Try the ribeye. And this one is definitely medium rare, the way I like it the best. Oh, that's so good. Much juicier. And more tender since it's medium rare. So that's the goal with these. They need to be cooked to a medium rare for the most tenderness. So that's that. So tomorrow we go out and we start to sell these. So that's it for tonight.